Hello guys, it's B013 and I'm back with another r/ video, and today I have r/ Tales from Retails and I have 5 stories for you guys. And as always, I have a hidden quote in my video. Before I start the video, I just want to say shout out to RX Memes. She said she'll do a 2K special for an hour. This one's titled, "Where are your Bluetooth cables?" I used to work at an electronics store and one day a customer came asking me where the Bluetooth cables are stored. Confused, I asked the customer what they are planning to use it for. See, customer, M, me. Customer, that's not your concern. Me. Okay, well, we have USB Bluetooth adapters which you can use with your computer and aux adapters to turn your non-Bluetooth hi-fi into a Bluetooth one. See, that's not a Bluetooth cable. Me. Thinking that the customer was referring to an aux lead, I take him to the leads. Customer. Where does it say that it's a Bluetooth cable? I want a Bluetooth cable. I want to speak to someone that knows what they're talking about. I am an audio engineer and have been for over 30 years, and I demand you show me your Bluetooth cables. Me. I'm sorry, sir, but we won't be able to help you this occasion as we don't sell Bluetooth cables. Customer. I want to speak to your manager. My manager said that we don't sell Bluetooth cables and that chap walked out. Yeah, I'm gonna flex. I know my stuff. 30 years, audio engineer, and I do not have a Bluetooth Wi-Fi. Weird flex, but all I have to say to you dude is, why the you lying? Why you always lying? Oh my gosh, I'm getting demonetized. But like, damn dude, don't lie. And this must have been an old story, because damn, I was like a baby bean, like what, when I was 7 or 8, when Bluetooth was a major thing. I know it's still around, but no one really uses it. This is titled, "Next time, make sure the person you road rage at isn't your cashier." Fuel clerk. We're an extension of a grocery store, and we don't have our own facilities, so the grocery store sends a clerk down to cover our register while we go to the store and use the bathroom. It's not far at all, maybe 300 feet, but I always take my car just because it's a little faster than walking and I feel safer in my car than I do walking through a parking lot for exactly this reason. I was on my way back to the gas station and as you leave the grocery store part, you have to stop at a four-way and then continue on the gas station. Well, I stopped and the man in a 15,000 truck behind me stopped. As I started to pull forward, for some reason he cuts out from behind me so that he's beside my car in the opposite traffic lane and proceeds to cut his wheel to the right, loudly flooring his truck so the exhaust roars directly in my ear and turning it directly in front of my car. If I wasn't just leaving from a dead stop, then I wouldn't have been able to stop in time. That's how close he was to ramming the front end of my car. Obviously, I laid on my horn as I slammed my brakes on and then continue once he also stops. Then he had the audacity to lay on his horn back at me and call me vulgar names out of the window. I watch him in the mirror as I pull into the gas station, hoping and praying that he leaves and doesn't turn in. No such luck. A few minutes later, he comes up to my window and doesn't recognize me, but I let him know that I'm the one he almost hit. I'll be me, he'll be MD for moron driver. He's mid-late 30s. Me. Hey, remember me, Red Corolla? You almost just mowed me down. Called me all kind of names? MD. You wouldn't move. What? MD. You were going way too slow, then you just stopped. I tried to go around you, and then you decided you wanted to move again. More colourful words used. Me. That's because that's a four-way stop. You have to wait your turn and stop? MD. Oh, my bad. Me. Yeah. MD. Casually leaves like nothing happened. Aww. I know people always say they hate me defending people, but come on, you must have at least once experienced road rage in your life. I don't care who you are, if you know how to drive, you must have experienced it at least once. Even if you're in the wrong, because at that moment, you don't know you're in the wrong, all you're thinking about is, damn, this douche almost got me hit, and I don't want to pay insurance. But like, damn. If I was that guy, maybe I'd say sorry, but yeah, I'd probably like, oh, sorry, my bad, and then probably act like it never happened. Because once you know you're in the wrong, you kind of just want to save face and run away. This one's titled, "Woman Gets Mad When I Get Sent For My Lunch Break." I work Saturdays, 1200 till 2100. My lunch is at 1600, and I would say it would have been a couple minutes past 1600 when I was about finishing serving the last couple customers I had at my till when my supervisor came over and told me to go on my lunch. So, as always, I do what I do when I'm in the middle of sales. I finish the sale, tell the customers to have a lovely weekend, and then proceed to place a till close sign over the front of the till and sign off the till. However, this time, after I had just placed the till close sign over the front of the till, this woman came up to the till and places her items onto the till and demanded that I serve her. I politely and calmly explained that I have just closed the till and I was about to go on my lunch hour. She proceeded to shout at me how this was terrible customer service and then walked off in a huff. Note, I must add I do not get paid for my lunch hour and I am expected to be on the shop floor at 1700, so anytime I spend longer on the shop floor is up to me and I do not get paid for it. Therefore, I do not serve the next person when sent to my lunch break. I only finish serving the person that I am serving, which most people in my company don't bother doing. Damn, what kind of place is this? I'd love the job like that. Imagine, oh, it's 4 o'clock and then it's your lunch break and you're just middle of serving someone. You're just like, peace out, adios, and just run away. I don't know what any place would do that because where I'm from in England, if you have 3 people and it's your lunch break, you have to do the close sign and then wait for those 3 people to be finished serving and then go. And the fact that you lose out your lunch break. Oh, hell no. I know people have those tracker thingies, so your card that you scan it in, but I would hate that. The fact that you lose your lunch break just serving customers. I know the customers are always right, but it's not true. Everyone lies. This one's titled, "You Open 10 Minutes Late." I work as a cashier in a big supermarket in the UK. I started working before the tills open on Sundays, so do other jobs for the first few hours of my shift. The store itself opened half an hour before the tills open. I happened to be at the front of the store, so was asked to open up and let the customers in, where I was met with a man who asked why we left everyone standing out in the cold. Let's say the store opens at 10:30. A quick glance on my watch tells me it's 10:33. I tell the guy that I just opened up when I was asked to, so he tells me to take him to whoever gave me the order to open up. I kind of eardrop on an ensuing mess as he asks my colleague why we opened 10 minutes late. It's shot down when they show him multiple clocks and watches that say it's only 10:35. At this point, he yells at one of my colleagues for not looking at him while he's talking to her. She glanced away for a moment to place a scanning handset into a rack, and then the man had the full attention of the other colleagues next to him, and then went on to the customer service to get them to contact the manager. What was his problem? I don't know if I'm the only person who does this, but I have issues. Like, if someone's pissed off at me randomly, I'll just make it my job just to annoy them that bit more. Like, if that man yelled at me, I'll just carry on and be like, look, sir, you have other people and I'm busy with more important things. Boom. There you have a raging man. Just like, you can imagine him just like, oh, if he was a cartoon character, he'll have steam coming out of him, like Majin Buu style. But like, you're asking for the manager, but no one's gonna care. Like what, are you gonna blame 20 people about the store opening up late? The manager's not gonna care. He's just gonna be like, we will investigate this and that proper precautions will take place. But you won't know because nothing's gonna change. This one's titled, "I have $7,000 in my pocket right now that I wanted to spend, but you won't be getting any of it." Man, working in retail really shows you what kind of people exist in the world, doesn't it? Yesterday, I was managing the floor at my store, greeting customers, delegating tasks to colleagues, etc. We had a launch on Friday of a new product, so we've been incredibly busy. Last night, during a really busy period, I was already with a customer when a man, walked past. He was wearing headphones and appeared to be talking to someone, so I smiled at him and said, "Hey, how are ya?" He ignored me and went to go browse at tablets. A minute later, literally a minute lol, I'm still with my customer, my staff are busy doing their jobs, and he begins to walk off talking to someone through his headphones. As he walks by, my customer begins to walk off too and says, "Bye guys, have a good night." Man turns around and starts yelling, "Man, have a good night? I've been in here for 5 minutes and not once was I asked if I needed help." Me: "I'm sorry, you are on the phone to someone and as you can see, we're all busy with customers. Is there something I can help you with?" Man: "On the phone?" Me: "Oh, it looked like you were speaking with someone. I thought you didn't hear me when I asked you how you were because you were in a conversation." Man: "Well, I wasn't, and I just want you to know that you've lost a customer, and I have $7,000 in my pocket right now that I wanted to spend, but you won't be getting any of it." He begins to walk away. Me: "No worries, mate. I hope your night gets better, man. I hope that's not sarcasm. He storms off into the shopping center and starts yelling at random people, warning them not to come in and announcing to the world that he's going to buy competitor's product. I had a chuckle when I saw he already had their product in his hand. Seems like a setup if you ask me. He already has a competitor's stuff, and if I was the competitor, I would do that. I'd pay someone money just to go to the other shop and sabotage. Because if I'm a small business, I'll be earning paper just stealing their customers. And anyone, do not try this if you ever have money, because where I'm from, if you say you have $7,000 and you walk out in the open, you're going to get yeeted, and then you're going to get robbed. And then your shoes are probably going to get stolen, because that's where I'm from. Anyways guys, that's the end of the video. Hope you guys like, comment, subscribe. Peace out.